In the following circuit, the time constant RC is much greater than the period of the input signal. Assume diode is ideal and resistance R to be very large. We have to find the DC output voltage across resistance R. So let us assume this diode is D1 and this diode is D2 and input voltage is given. So input is 24 volt VRMS. So peak value will be Vm and this will be under root 2 times VRMS. So peak value of the input is 24 root 2 volt. Now we have to identify in which half cycle D1 conducts. So D1 will conduct during negative half cycle. So let us draw equivalent. This is the capacitor. D1 conducts, so it is short circuited. Input is negative half cycle, so you will get minus plus. This value is Vm. Diode conducts in this direction. So polarity of the voltage across capacitor is Vc. D2 is open circuited because it is reverse bias. So this is capacitor C and this is resistance R. In this case, charging time of the capacitor will be zero because diode is an ideal, so resistance will be zero. Now if we apply KVL in this loop, we will get voltage drop across Vc. So that is plus Vm minus Vc plus 0 is 0. So Vc is Vm. So capacitor is charged up to Vm. Now draw equivalent during positive half cycle. So again, this capacitor voltage will be minus plus. This is Vm. Now D1 is open circuited. So positive half cycle plus minus. Now D2 will be short circuited. And resistance R is parallel to C. Now this time capacitor voltage will try to discharge through R. So discharging time is RC, and RC is very large as compared to the half period of the input. So during this time interval, capacitor will hold the voltage. So we can easily find output voltage. If we apply KVL in this loop, we will get minus Vm plus Vo is 0. So Vo is 2 Vm. So output voltage is 2 Vm, that is 2 into 24 root 2 volt, and this will be 68 volt. So numerical value is 6.